Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Anuj Jindal and today we are going to pick up another essay topic and talk about it in detail, understand how to write an essay, what are the points you can keep in mind while writing an essay, and all this will be done by picking up one essay topic out of the test series available for enrolled students. So let's move on to the essay. If you like this session, do not forget to subscribe to the channel, press the bell icon so that you are well prepared for the upcoming RBI examination. The essay topic for today is, what steps are required to convert India's demographic liability into demographic dividend? The first step of our activity of writing the essay is to identify the keywords. Number one, we have to identify the steps. What steps are required to what? Convert India's demographic, we are talking about India, not global, demographic liability into demographic dividend. So we just have to talk about how India can convert its demographic liability into demographic dividend, or in other words, how it can utilize its youth in such a way that they are productive in nature. That is what is the meaning of demographic dividend, right? So that is what we have to, in short, write in this essay. In the introduction, you can talk about or just define what is demographic dividend. At the same time, you can talk about the importance of demographic dividend for a nation. As I had mentioned in the last video, that demographic dividend and the keywords are to be defined in the introduction, and we talk about the importance of the keywords as well. And this is what I've done here. Makes it very simple, right? Now, in the body part, you will jump directly to the steps required to convert demographic liability into demographic dividend. Probably 4 to 5 steps, 6 steps if possible, you can mention. And in the conclusion, we will just summarize it, or we will provide a way forward. Now, these steps have to be multidimensional in nature, from economic dimension, from population dimension, from skilling dimension, education, health dimension, political dimension. You have to try and pick up majority of different dimensions. Now, what have I mentioned here? Number one is skilling the youth. If this youth is not skilled, there is no way they can be productive, and there is no way they can be utilized in the economy efficiently. Therefore, skilling makes the most important part of our entire activity of converting or trying to convert demographic liability into dividend. Second is controlling population explosion. So if you have some population explosion which is happening in India, PM Modi has also talked about it, you need to control it to be able to provide opportunities, enough opportunities to the available people. Let's say your population is expanding at the rate of 100 people per day, but the opportunities that you can provide have a limit of, let's say, 50 per day. No way, even if you increase this 50 to, let's say, 75, 80, 90, even if you increase it to 100, if there is a population explosion, this 100 might increase to 200 tomorrow. In this situation, there is no way that you can provide or you can sustain maintaining the quality of youth. Okay, therefore, controlling population explosion is one major step that you need to take. Third is more opportunities to explore. Presently, the entire youth population is being pushed into either manufacturing or conventional services. There are there are a lot of opportunities that people can explore, but those are not made available. For example, a very simple example. When you go to a market, let's say you go to Connaught Place in Delhi, you go to Khan Market in Delhi, you go to any other place in Delhi, or let's say there are some markets, Mumbai, similar markets, Hiranandani and all those in Mumbai or in Delhi. So what do you see there? You see all those big box retailers, you see all big companies, food giants, but do you see enough space in those areas where people can play the guitar, play some music, perform whatever they know, you do some arts, and probably sell those activities for money? You don't see that opportunities being available, because the idea of exploring with yourself with something new other than studies or other than sports or other than conventional manufacturing or services that we've been providing is very limited in our country. It's not given a lot of importance. It's not attached to a lot of money. And therefore, it remains in the backdoor. Now, what happens when you provide more opportunities to people through these markets? A very simple example that I've taken. Let's say hundreds of artists are available out there in Connaught Place. Hundreds of musicians are available out there, and they're playing on a daily basis on the road itself, because it's a walkable path. People can listen to them. People can pay them for whatever their activities, whatever their professionalism or expertise is. And that encourages young people to adopt something like this, to go out and take that risk, because they know that even if nothing works out, they can earn a living. Now, those opportunities are very limited in our country because of our obsession with manufacturing, providing basic or conventional services just to make a living. The fourth one is minimum basic income can provide the security to individuals to allow them to explore. I know that there are certain criticisms attached with minimum basic income, but here we have to write the advantages of minimum basic income, because that syncs completely with exploration, the idea of exploration. If you have some minimum basic income, you would be able to go out and take that risk, because you know that the government is going to take care of your education, the government is going to take care of your health in case you fall sick, the government is going to provide you a basic housing. Therefore, these people can now go out and take those risks, which will allow them to do a lot better. Fifth is incentivizing firms to hire more and expand. Present set of laws disincentivize companies to expand. Now, this is a very important point taken from the legal point of view. Presently, the firms in India do not want to expand beyond a certain point, because the laws, the set of laws that they get into because of expansion end up hurting these companies and their owners, and therefore their owners want to limit themselves. Only when they're able to expand and grow, they will be able to hire more people, which means more employment for the people, which means better demographic dividend. Better health options to the youth so that they can grow into healthy and productive employers and employees. Now, presently, a lot of malnutrition, a lot of undernutrition also affects mental as well as physical health of the youth in India. If they are more healthy, they will be in a better position to contribute towards demographic dividend. Inculcating a culture of self-employment in order to provide domestic employment opportunities and take forward Make in India. Now, the culture of self-employment is just started to grow up. It used to be very limited in India. We were crazy about getting employed somewhere and talking about our packages. You all must be aware about that. The culture of self-employment is now growing in India, and we need to inculcate that culture even more so that the youth itself can create job opportunities for a lot of other youth in the economy. Okay, so that is what will enhance and grow demographic dividend in India and ensure that the youth does not turn into demographic liability in the country. Okay, so this was about second topic. We will move towards the third topic.